Students, we'll see with the sixth type of problem in Taylor series method. This problem is very important. You have to pay attention here. What exactly we are doing here is, here what is the difference? You'll understand when I'm explaining the problem. Okay. So question is: use Taylor series method to solve y dash is equals to x square plus y in the range 0 less than or equals to x less than or equals to 0.2. By taking step size h equals to 0.1, given that y is equals to 10 at x equals to 0 initially, considering terms up to the fourth degree. Now in this problem, if you observe previous problems, we used to have only the expression and the initial conditions were given. That is x and y values were given. But now here extra information they have mentioned is step size. When they mention step size means you have to concentrate in how many stages we have to find for the values. Here they have mentioned the range 0 to 0.2. Means here y of 0 you are having, because x is 0 means corresponding y value is 10. The next value to be found out is we have to find for y of 0.1. When x is 0.1, what is y we have to find. Next, we have to find for when x is 0.2, y, what is y value. Since I mentioned this part, so h is 0.1 means the stage, the whatever the problem will be solved will be in two stages. For the first stage, it will be to compute y of 0.1. And then in the second stage, we'll be computing for y of 0.2. Here the difference I'll let you know in the next of my steps. Given you have to write h is 0.1, y is 10 at x equals to 0. Here I'm mentioning, since step size is mentioned as h is equals to 0.1, we need to compute the problem in two stages, because here I am finally ending up with 0.2. So the step size is 0.1 means first I'll find for 0.1 value, then we'll go for 0.2. So I'm mentioning it as two stage problem. Okay. So in first stage, we will compute what y at x equals to 0.1 means I'm going to find y of 0.1. In the second stage, we'll compute for y at x equals to 0.2. That is y of 0.2. Okay. If the value was ending with 0.3 and the step size was mentioned 0.1, means the problem would be solved in three stages. Means the third stage will be to compute y at x equals to 0.3. Okay, likewise. Now, in first stage, the initial values will be x naught given, that is 0, and y naught given 10. But in the second stage, we are not going to consider these as the initial values. We are going to consider the values which I have got in the first stage. Okay, that is I am going to consider x naught as 0.1, and what will be the corresponding y value, that will be your y naught. Okay, this is what the main thing to understand. Do not get confused. Now to start stage 1, I'll write to compute y of 0.1. Given is what? Y dash is equals to x square plus y. X naught is 0, y naught is 10. Write for the Taylor series expansion up till 4th degree, because they have told up till 4th degree. Where all x naught is there, substitute 0. Where all y of x naught is there, substitute there 10, because y naught is 10. Okay. So substituting the values, mark it as equation number 1. Now we need to compute for y dash of 0, y double dash of 0, y triple dash of 0, and y raised to 4 of 0. So I'll start computing y dash of 0. Consider the given expression, that is y dash is equals to x square plus y. Y dash means it is y dash of x naught. Where all x is there, write it as x naught. Where all y is there, write it as y naught. X naught is 0 the square plus y naught is 10. Hence y naught of 0 is 10. Next, to compute y double dash of 0, consider y dash is equals to x square plus y. Differentiating both sides with respect to x. Derivative of y dash is y double dash. Derivative of x square, now I have to separately differentiate because plus sign is there. Derivative of x square is 2x plus derivative of y is y dash. Where all x is their substitute x naught, where all y is y dash is their substitute as y dash of x naught, and this becomes y double dash of x naught. Substitute x naught as 0, y dash of 0 as 10. Simplifying, you will get y double dash of 0. Next, to compute for y triple dash of 0, you consider the expression for y double dash of. This is a simplified form you should consider. Now differentiate both sides with respect to x. Derivative of y double dash will become y triple dash. 2 is acting as a constant, so keep it as it is. Derivative of x is 1 plus derivative of y dash is y double dash. Where all x naught, y triple dash is there, you write it as y triple dash of x naught. Where all x is there, substitute x naught. And where all y double dash is there, write it as y double dash of x naught. What is x naught? It is 0. So y triple dash of 0 is equals to 2 plus y double dash of 0. Y double dash of 0, you take it from here, that is 10. 10 plus 2, it is 12. This is the third, what is y triple dash of 0. Next, I'll start to compute for y raised to 4. So y raised to 4, if I have to compute, I'll consider y triple dash simplified form. So y triple dash is equals to 2 plus y double dash. Differentiating both sides with respect to x. Y triple dash derivative will become y raised to 4 plus derivative of 2 is 0 plus derivative of y double dash is y triple dash. So y raised to 4 of x naught is equals to y triple dash of x naught. That is y raised to 4 of 0 is equals to y triple dash of 0. Hence y raised to 4 of 0 is equals to 12. So this is what we will get for y raised to 4. Substituting in equation 1, this will be the solution for the given differential equation. Now I need to compute for y of 0.1. So where all x is a substitute 0.1. Simplify on the calculator, you will get 11.052 as y of 0.1. The problem will not end now, because still we have to go up till the second stage. So I'll start with the second stage now here. In the second stage, we are going to compute for y of 0.2. Given y dash is equals to x square plus y. Now what are the initial conditions, x naught and y naught? Are you going to consider for the previous only, the initially given? No. You have to take the previous readings values, previous stage values. So this will be your x naught and this will be your y naught. With the help of that, we are going to proceed. Procedure will be same. Only the change is to take x naught and y naught in the second stage. So to start, write for the Taylor series expansion. Since they have said up till 4th degree, write up till 4th degree. So where all x naught is their substitute, 0.1. Okay. Therefore, this x y of 0.1 plus x minus 0.1 into y dash of 0.1 plus x minus 0.1 the whole square upon 2 factorial y double dash of 0.1 plus x minus 0.1 the whole cube upon 3 factorial y triple dash of 0.1 plus x minus 0.1 raised to 4 upon 4 factorial into y raised to 4 of 0.1. So y double dash of here 0.1, we need to compute for y dash of 0.1, y double dash of 0.1, y triple dash of 0.1 and y raised to 4 of 0.1 we need to compute. Y of 0.1 we have to write it as 11.052 from the previous reading. Okay. So to proceed now, substituting the values. Now considering to compute y dash of 0.1, y double dash of 0.1, y triple dash of 0.1 and y raised to 4 of 0.1. So consider same equation we have to consider. Differentiation also will be same for all the four parts. Y dash of x naught square plus y naught square. You should be very aware while substituting the values. Do not get confused. Now x naught is 0.1. X naught is 0.1 the whole square plus y naught is 11.052. Simplifying, I'll get y dash of 0.1. Now to compute for y double dash, consider y dash. Differentiating both sides, this becomes y double dash is equals to 2x plus y dash. That is y double dash of x naught is equals to 2x naught plus y dash of x naught. That is y double dash of 0.1 is equals to 2 into 0.1 plus y dash of 0.1. 2 into 0.1 it is 0.2. Y dash of 0.1 it is 11.062. That is 11.262 is your y double dash of 0.1. Next, y triple dash of 0.1. Consider y double dash simplified expression. Differentiating both sides with respect to x. Y double dash derivative is y triple dash. 2 as it is, since it is into, derivative of x is 1 plus derivative of y dash is y double dash. Hence y triple dash is equals to 2 plus y double dash. Hence y triple dash of x naught is equals to 2 plus y double dash of x naught. That is y triple dash of 0.1 is equals to 2 plus y double dash of 0.1. That is y triple dash of 0.1 is equals to 2 plus 11.262. Adding will get 13.262. Now I'll compute for y raised to 4 of 0.1. So consider the simplified form of y triple dash. Differentiating both sides, y raised to triple dash will become y raised to 4. Derivative of 2 is 0. Y double dash derivative will become y triple dash. That is y raised to 4 is equals to y triple dash. Y raised to 4 of x naught is equals to y triple dash of x naught. That is y raised to 4 of 0.1 is equals to y triple dash of 0.1. That is 13.262. All the values when we compute, we are going to substitute in the Taylor series expansion. Once we substitute, we are going to compute for y of 0.2. Means where all x is there, substitute 0.2. So substituting, simplifying on the calculator, you will get y of 0.2 as 12.2168. That is the numerical solution for the given differential equation. Thank you.